Thank you for seeing my videos, thank you for subscribing to my channel. And today what I'm going to do, I'm going to do an unboxing of this power supply, the Smart SE. If I forget any from the details, I'm going to write them on the description below. So let's go. This power supply, as you can see, it's from Thermaltake. It's an 530 watts. So I needed to buy one that has at least 500 watts, so I can use a new graphic card that I'm going to buy. And so I bought this one of 530 watts. So as you can see, it has all the security measures, a quiet fan, so it has all the connections and the cables in order you to connect the power supply to the drivers in your computer. So this is the silicone. Do not eat and throw it and don't do anything with that. So opening the plastic bag, inside you're going to see in a second, you're going to see the power supply. Thumbs up for the light there. So this is the power supply, and the power supply has 6 connections. You can see the upper connections, they are going to be for the PCIe connector. The other connections that you can see underneath, they are going to be for the SATA, PATA, whatever connection that you have to connect your other drivers, like your HDD. So yeah, plastic that needs to take out from there, because if not, it's going to smell and it's going to melt from the heat that is going to produce when you are using the power supply. And this is the power supply. So as you can see from the side, it's an 87% efficient. These are the connections. I think they wanted to put more connections, therefore you have this this stick. So I don't know why they are putting also a bag with it, but they put a bag. In the bag, another bag with the connections that you need for your drivers, and in order to connect to your power supply. Doesn't trying to take him out from this plastic bag. And there are other plastic bag with another cable, and this cable is going to be the cable to connect to your power supply and to connect to the electricity, so you can use the power supply, and also some ties. And those are the screws for the power supply, as you can see, and those are the ties for the power supply. Or if you don't have any ties, you can use them to do the cable management. So this is the cable. This is an European cable because I'm in Europe, so I need the Europe type. And this is the SATA. From one side is the connection to the power supply, and the other you have the SATA, and this is another SATA, and that has also a connection from one side to the power supply, and the other to the SATA connection. And those are Molex connections that connects also to the power supply. So those are the PCIe connections. As you see, you connected one side to the power supply, then the other to PCIe's, depends on the power that you need. And this is the 24 pins that you are putting to your motherboard, so you can have also a power for your motherboard. And now I'm going to show you. Yes, so this is the CPU connect. So you have the connections for your drivers, and they are modular, but the connections for the CPU and the connection to the 24 pins that is going to connect to the motherboard. It's not modular, so it's fixed to the power supply. So the length of the power supply is going to be 13.5 centimeters. Also put the inches, and the diameter of the fan is going to be 15 centimeters, although it says on the box that it's going to be 13 centimeters. And the width of the power supply is going to be 16.5 centimeters. As always, I put also the inches, so you can see the inches if you are living, for example, in the United States and you want to know the inches. If you like this video, like the video. If you dislike the video, dislike the video. Thank you for seeing the video and have a nice day.